G'day guys, Chrissy from Spartan, and welcome to the first of our kettlebell training tips with our superstar Elna. Elna is the first CMS in Sweden and on her way to becoming world-class master of sport. So today we're going to take a look at the rack position after the clean, which is really important, especially if you're thinking about competing. So I'm just going to get Elna to clean the bell up into that position. I'm going to ask her advice on what's important for the rack position.
Well, first I would try to rest on my hip.
Okay, so as you can see, Elna's actually sunken. Yeah, good, turn to the side. Sinking your elbow right down to her hip. This helps you relax quite a lot, doesn't it?
Yes, yeah. And it will make me save energy.
Perfect, perfect. What else are you thinking about when you're trying to get the bell into that position?
To rest my hand.
Okay.
So I not will overbend it.
Okay, so you don't want it to be bent back too far.
No.
But at the same time, you don't want to be gripping it too tight. And you can see it's sitting nice and close to the center of her chest. So another really important point. What else are we thinking about?
The lockout in your knees and your hips.
Yep. And this again helps you to relax and helps you to settle the kettlebell when you get it up to the top position.
And especially when you are competing.
Okay, why is that?
Because you will get an outcome.
Okay, so can you turn to the side again for us? So you can see Elna's knees and hips are actually forwards, and this is creating that base of support for the kettlebell to sit on. So as she says, really important for relaxing, but also in competition, if you fail to get this position, you won't get a lift, will you?
Yes.
Okay, so there's three really good points you want to think about with your rack position. The first one, the elbow into the hip to help you relax. The second one, we'll get Elna to turn around and see that beautiful hand position. It's nice and relaxed. She's not gripping it too hard, but at the same time, it's not bending your wrist back. And the third one, going on to her knees and hips, making sure that they're in full lockout position. Firstly, so you can relax, and second, so you can actually get that lift if you're thinking about competing. There you go, guys, some fantastic tips from Elna. And you can check out more at kettlebells.nu.